You doing your thing. You wanted a hitman.
Mm-hmm.
Work with Diddy. You doing your thing. I'm proud of you.
I appreciate it, man. It's been a long road, you know. And
you've produced for so many people.
Yeah, I produce, you know, we had thisis50.com, you know, and every time I talk about it, I always say that I've been privileged to produce for over 50 artists.
Wow.
You know what I'm saying? So this is monumental. You know, I'm glad to be here, glad to chop it up with you.
Amadeus. What's the meaning behind Amadeus? What kind of name is that?
It actually means loves God. I got it from the composer, Wolfgang Mozart Amadeus, who was a legend back in the day, man. I actually was forced to watch the movie in school. I didn't really pay attention at the time because I didn't, you know, but as I got older, I got to really understand who this dude was. And I was like, you know, I want to use this name because of what he's accomplished. And if I can be the Amadeus of hip hop, why not? You know, I'm from the projects, man. So.
Oh, you from the project? What project you from? Soundview?
No, Washington.
Washington Heights?
169th Washington Avenue.
Oh, where? So what was it like growing up in the projects, Washington, 116th, and that other street?
Tough. I ain't gonna lie, man. It was tough. You know, my mom didn't really let me go outside too often. I went to Catholic school, so I had to wear the uniform. And, you know, that wasn't really cool. So, you know, when everybody else had the Jordans, I had the hard black, you know, pointy toe shoes, shiny joints.
Did you go to college too?
I started out, you know, I did something real gangster, right? You know,
what'd you do? You dropped out?
Yeah, dropped out.
Man. You dropped out after what year?
Like a month.
After a month. Man, that's gangster right there. That's gangster right there. Your mama should have whooped your ass.
You know, it was on the way, but I was
school was college for you.
I was borderline grown. I'll tell you how I did it, though.
Okay.
Went upstairs with the dean. I said, I think today's going to be my last day. He was like, well, what happened? I said, just ain't really adding up.
That makes sense.
You know, I don't really see it. And he was like, you know, I'm honestly supposed to talk you out of withdrawing from college. You know, I can't, you know, support you with that. He said, but for some reason, you know, I feel like you're going to make it. I feel like this is what, you know, you're supposed to be doing. And I just see, you know, there's a look that you have in your eye that tells me, yeah, you're going to really go, you know, full steam, you know, full speed ahead and do this.
And so, like, what's been the highlight of your career? Who was the person that you was, like, really excited to work with?
And I know you might think, you know, it's because I'm here, man, but, like, 50, no?
No, I'm man. Excited to work with him. That makes sense.
You know, 50, if I was able to name a few, I would definitely say 50. Lil Wayne, Chris Brown.
Wow.
You know, Trey Songz.
Trey Songz.
You know, I can...
The list goes on.
The list goes on.
So right.
I'll leave it at that.
Who haven't you worked with that you'd love to work with?
Definitely got to say Jay-Z.
Wow.
Usher. Beyonce.
Mm-hmm.
Madonna,
wow.
You know, to really flip the script because I produce in different genres.
Mm-hmm.
Kurt Franklin. You know, I can work with anybody, man.
Mm-hmm.
You know, from gospel to pop to rock to dance to trance. Like, I just create music. I'm a musician first, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, that allows me to be able to tap into the different areas of music and genres, you know, so I do it all.
Mm-hmm.
In order for me to sell a record to someone like 50 or, you know, the various artists that are out today, I have to believe in it first.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if I don't believe in it, how can I convince someone else to?
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? So when I create, I love it. And after I love it, I can try to convince the world and the artists that I pitched music to love it as well.
Mm-hmm. And so you went on the road with Trey Songz, mm-hmm. man. You worked with him, you know, you produced for him. And shit, you know, elaborate on that situation. Tell me exactly what was the situation with you and Trey.
Well, you know, I met Trey in the studio. I was actually working on Mike Jones' album at the time. And that was a time where we were in the studio together.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so, you know, things came about in that session. You know, Trey came down to Houston. I flew down to Houston. We mixed the records. Trey was on a song called I Know with mm-hmm. Mike Jones.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, they had a drum set in the studio.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, y'all play drums. And the cat's just like, I don't play no drums, man. I'm like, yo, this is where it started. Like, me as a drummer, this is before producing, before any of that. I was a musician. When you need a band, you know, give me a shout, and I'll put it together. And, you know, a year later, I got a call from his manager. You know, shout out to Delonte Murphy. Called me up and was just like, you ready to put the band together? And 5 years later, we're here now. You know, I've been able to travel the world with him as his music director and tour drummer.
Today.
Mm-hmm. And it's been an amazing experience, man.
Yeah, so let me ask you this, man. So would you say that a good producer slash beat maker should be a musician too?
I mean, it helps.
It helps. Because how was being a musician helped your beat making?
Because of how I've been trained and what I've been taught musically. Mm. Like, I really understand what I'm creating. I can tell you what I'm doing, you know, in a musical way. Mm. You know what I mean? I'm playing, you know, in C. Mm. You know, and like C. That's C is the key. Mm. You know, so I'm aware of what I'm doing. Mm. And I'm aware of the possibilities and what I'm able to add to my music. Just want to inspire any producer that's out there to keep going. Keep going. It's rough. The game is changing, you know, but... you know, the first thing I would say is be passionate about what you do. You know, there's got to be a passion. The only way I feel you really make it is to be passionate, because there's going to be some, you know, some rough turns, man, some rough moments. And the only way that you keep doing this is by going off the passion. Shout out to my artist, Tiffany Mignon, Angel of R&B. Got a single out right now, two singles out right now. Mm-hmm. I Know How to Love You.com and Dance the Night Away featuring Fred the Godson. So be on the lookout, you know, for both of those, man. But I'm happy to be here, man.
Already, man. So, with that being said, like I always say, you just can't say you're real. It's something you gotta be. Hey, do I have something in my eye? And remember, everybody, it's always bitches over money.